Okay, whoa. Spider-Man, whoa. There's a lot to process here. There's love stories, alien imposters, Jake Gyllenhaal. So let's get to it. I should start this video with a hefty spoiler warning. If you haven't seen Far From Home yet, then proceed with caution because we're going to be discussing a lot of pretty important details from the movie. I'll give you 5 seconds to decide if you want to stay or Spider-Man dies. I'm just kidding. That's not true. But if you're still sticking around, that means you've either seen the movie or you're an intelligent sicko who'd rather spend 10 minutes watching a YouTube video instead of spend $20 at the movie theater and just get the same info. So Peter Spider-Man does not, in fact, die. However, a ton of other really important things happen. This movie marks the official conclusion to Marvel's Phase 3 and gets Phase 4 started with a bang. Here's a quick recap of what went down in Far From Home. The action starts with Nick Fury and Maria Hill squaring off against the Earth Elemental, but failing to defeat it without the help of Quentin Beck, who makes the save. Elsewhere, Peter Parker and all his newly snapped back to reality Oh There Goes Gravity classmates go on a trip to Europe. Why? Because everyone is sad that half of humanity just missed the last 5 years, and what better way to get your mind off it than some pasta? Peter's still wicked bummed about his mentor Tony Stark passing away, and wants this trip to be drama and Spider-Man free. Just a fun trip with his normal teenage friends. While it's a nice thought, that would make for a pretty boring movie, and certainly not at all what happens. Peter and his friends are attacked in Italy by the Water Elemental, but yet again, Jake Gyllenhaal seems to be in the right place at the right time is there to save the day. Nick Fury shows up and gives Peter some special glasses that belong to Tony Stark and are meant for his successor. These aren't just ordinary glasses. That would be an odd thing for Tony Stark to leave Peter. No, these are Edith glasses. That's not a brand like Oakley or Ray-Ban, that's the technology database installed into them, much like Tony's Jarvis. A bit later, in Prague, we get the Fire Elemental, which, for those scoring at home, makes 3 of the 4 elementals now. One more and you've got a full Captain Planet. Peter and Mysterio fight it together and win, and then Peter gives Quentin his fancy new Tony Stark Edith glasses. It's Peter's way of saying, I don't want to do this, I trust you, so here, you be the hero. Then things kinda hit the fan like Ron Artest at a Pistons game. Peter's newly secured girlfriend MJ figures out his alter ego.
I am Spider-Man.
No, of course I'm not.
And then uncovers the air elemental and the fact that it's just a crappy illusion by a crappy illusionist, Quentin Beck, who's also been behind all of these attacks. I guess they forgot to mention the part where MJ becomes a master detective. So it turns out that Mysterio actually used to work for Tony Stark, but got fired because he's an insane and bad person. And that's who Peter gifted Tony's Alexa glasses to?
Will the real Slim Shady please stand up?
Spider-Man tries to get help from Nick Fury, but it turns out that he's an illusion as well. Finally, Peter's real eyes, and it's tough to know what's fake and what's not. Peter's finally able to get some help from an actual existing person, Happy Hogan, who gives Peter some sort of Tony Stark tech suit building machine. Peter creates a dope new Spidey suit that he utilizes to defeat Mysterio and get his glasses back. Now, I'm not saying that I was rooting for the villain here, but it's kind of rude to take back a gift. I'm just saying. During the whole melee, Mysterio accidentally gets shot by a misfired gun, and it's bye-bye Quentin. The movie ends with Peter returning to New York with a cool new girlfriend. As is the case with a lot of Marvel movies, perhaps the most useful parts take place after the movie ends. In the first post-credit scene, we see J. Jonah Jameson, once again played by J.K. Simmons, outing Peter Parker as Spider-Man and labeling him a villain. He shows some doctored footage of Spider-Man being the one responsible for Mysterio's demise, which isn't actually true. So not only does everyone now know that he's Spider-Man, but they all think that he's a bad guy. That certainly leaves things different than when this movie started. In the second post-credit scene, the Skrulls, Talos and Soran, are revealed to have been masquerading around as Nick Fury and Maria Hill this whole time. But rather than this be the secret invasion we're expecting, it turns out that Nick Fury actually knew about it and was just vacationing on a spaceship the entire time, probably hanging out with Captain Marvel. So was he just being lazy? Why hire an alien imposter to do your job? And how long has this Skrull been parading around as Fury? For all we know, it could have been the fake Fury we've been seeing for multiple movies now. And this also means that when Spider-Man discovers Fury to be just a Mysterio illusion near the end of the movie, he was actually discovering a fake of an imposter. That's a lot of layers of trickery and deceit. Alright, so what the heck does all of this actually mean? I think the biggest takeaway is that everyone now knows that Peter Parker is Spider-Man. That's surely gonna shift the dynamic of all future Spider-Man movies, and potentially the MCU as a whole. Not only is his identity now known, but he's also widely considered to be dangerous and a bad guy. That ain't great. Peter's also essentially taking over the mantle from his mentor Tony Stark. He's been hand-selected as his successor, and now has that fancy Edith technology. It'll be interesting to see how this factors into any new Avengers titles moving forward. With the original squad mostly out of the picture, it's possible that Peter takes over as the leader of a newer, younger team. For those less interested in all the action and fighting and who just care about the love story dynamic, you're probably happy that Peter and MJ are now finally dating. That's cute and heartwarming, but it'll likely factor into the next movie as part of the conflict. There's no guarantee that that's true, but Marvel loves using issues with girlfriends as motivation for male heroes to get revenge or something. That's their go-to move. One thing that I found interesting was that there was no actual multiverse. After all the talk of multiple realities and timelines in the previous Avengers movies, and with the previews showing Mysterio claiming to be from another reality,
Vic is from Earth, just not ours.
I was sure that they'd finally expand on the multiverse. Nope, it was all a trick. Kinda like Mysterio. It can definitely still play a factor in the MCU at some point, or perhaps they just toss that word around to distract us and it's not even a real thing. While on the subject of things I was excitedly expecting that never came to happen, there was no Sinister Six. The rumor was that we'd at least get a tease to this group of villains in the post-credit scene, but there was nothing. Marvel has gotten so good at their surprise post-credit scenes that I'm actually starting to get surprised when they don't do the surprise I was expecting. I still think the Sinister Six will play a part in the MCU's Phase 4, or perhaps even Phase 5 if they choose to take things extra slowly. Especially if Peter Parker is the leader of a new group of Avengers, then they'd make a pretty perfect squad of baddies to go up against. Kinda like a, you know, 6-on-6, full court, call your own fouls. There was also no Norman Osborn. That doesn't mean that he won't appear in the MCU sometime soon, but I, along with a lot of other people, was expecting his debut in this movie. Osborn is expected to be the focal point of the main Secret Invasion storyline, but getting him involved in the action so soon, I guess isn't entirely necessary. After all, they have multiple movies over several years to tell this story, so there's no need to rush everything right off the bat. They did, however, drop some hints about the Skrull. For those unfamiliar with the Secret Invasion arc, it's where a bunch of evil alien Skrull come to Earth and low-key take over the identities of many of Earth's top heroes and positions of power. While the Skrull are still being depicted as good guys working alongside Nick Fury, they are finally showing us their ability to go undercover and pretend to be different people. Since their on-screen introduction was in Captain Marvel, which takes place in the 90s, one can only imagine how many Skrull are already undercover in the MCU. The invasion is almost certainly already started, but they just aren't known villains yet. Far From Home also kind of featured the introduction to the Elementals. Alright, they were phonies, but at least we are introduced to the idea of the Elementals. With a standalone movie of their own already slated for production, it's smart of Marvel to start getting audiences accustomed to some brand new characters before their actual movie gets released. The Elementals in this movie turned out to be some Mysterio nonsense, but it planted the seed that these things actually exist and are pretty awesome. I'm curious if this Far From Home hoax will factor into the actual Elementals movie whatsoever. Speaking of Mysterio and his trickery, can we really believe that he actually passed away? I mean, it's safe to assume that he doctored that awful Spider-Man footage that the world has now seen. It's completely possible that he faked his own death thanks to some illusions. That would by no means whatsoever be beneath him.
All right.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say that it's not the last we've seen of Quentin Beck and that he'll be back in the next Spider-Man movie. Now that Homecoming and Far From Home are in the books, we know there's at least one more Spider-Man movie in the pipeline. It'll surely center around the fact that Peter Parker is now outed as Spider-Man and considered a bad guy to the public. He'll have to save his image and prove his innocence to the masses. He'll also probably have to deal with a not-so-dead Mysterio still causing problems for him. By the time the next Spider-Man movie comes out, we'll also probably be a lot deeper into the Secret Invasion story. My prediction is that Spider-Man 3 will feature Norman Osborn and the Sinister Six going up against Spider-Man, which will then transition right into the Dark Avengers, which Marvel has already mentioned plans for. Oh, and we'll get more of J.K. Simmons as J. Jonah Jameson. I mean, what more could you ask for? What are your thoughts about Far From Home? Did it meet your expectations? How do you see things playing out for Spider-Man going forward? Let us know in the comments down below. We love hearing your thoughts. Before you go, make sure to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to Behind the Screen to stay up to date on all of our latest releases. Until next time, bye!